Hey students, welcome back. This is 15.4. If you want to read more about it, you can. We actually skip around because AP doesn't use all of it, but we're going to get there. The other thing I want you to make notice is, whoo buddy, look at this. Our formulas are right there. This is basically all of kinetics formulas right there for us. So please make sure to check that out on your equation sheet. In our last video, we talked about how to find the order of a reaction based on the initial rate method. We're going to today use what is called the integrated rate law. So we're talking about changes over time, and our integrated rate law basically is our relationship between the concentration of the reactants and time. And we're going to start with the easiest first and kind of work out. So we have our zero order integrated rate law. I added this, sorry, I forgot to put it in when I was typing initially. Hopefully it won't be a problem on yours. I will fix it on yours as well. Our zero order, I didn't mean to say that. We have, this is the order it is written on your equation sheet. But another way to look at this is, and we're just rearranging, A sub t is equal to negative kt plus A sub o. All right. This also looks a little familiar, like, kind of like this here, right? So hopefully we can see that, but let's talk about what each of these mean before we get way into it. All right, so A sub t is concentration after some time has passed. Right? A sub O is our initial concentration. Our K is still our, it's also going to be our slope. That's where my mind went first, but it's also our rate constant. And T is that time that has passed. And remember, our rate law is rate equals K times the concentration of A raised to the zero power, right? This is zero order. All right. And our label on that would be molarity per second. All right. But we'll talk about that later. So now let's look at this in these terms. So I rearranged this to make it look kind of like a linear situation. And we have y equals mx plus b. So our slope, this is our slope, negative k. B is our y-intercept. But we basically what happens here is when we graph concentration versus time, we will get a straight line. And so if I do that and I get a straight line, when I graph concentration versus time, I know that the reaction is zero order. Take a second for that to soak in. If I graph concentration versus time and I get a straight line with a negative slope, right? Negative K, then I know this is a first order reaction. So I could actually just see a graph, concentration versus time, and it's a straight line. Hey, I know it's zero order. Awesome. Let's kind of relook at that with our first order integrated rate law. So here is our first order integrated rate law. Here's the formula that you see on the sheet. It is natural log of a sub t minus natural log of a sub zero equals negative kt. Again, let's rearrange that into what might be helpful to see in terms of y equals mx plus b. So we got natural log of a sub t is equal to negative kt, still a negative slope, plus natural log of a to the zero. So in this situation, all right, if I graph natural log of concentration versus time and get a straight line, then I know it is first order. Awesome. Please remember that. This is like the most important part right here and right here. All right. Yes, we can do some calculations with it, like right here. All right. So in example 15.3, we determined our given The decomposition is first order. It has a rate constant of positive 2.90 times 10 to the negative 4th seconds to the negative 1. If the reaction is carried out at the same temperature and the initial concentration of SO2 is 0.0225, what is the concentration after 865? So we can just plug in and solve here, right? Solve for our answer. It doesn't ask us to graph anything, but it's very simple. We just use our formula right there. Natural log of A sub T. That's what we're trying to find, right? So I'm just going to leave that as is. All right. And then we've got minus natural log of, we started at 0.0225. And then is equal to negative KT. Well, there's our K. 2.90 times 10 to the negative 4th. And then our temp is 865, right? And then we can just plug it in and solve. All right. And we could also move this to the other side if we wanted. That would probably be helpful, right? Excuse me, that equal sign shouldn't be there. All right, we'll just put it down here. Plus natural log of 0.0225. All right. So we do our calculating and we get... Turn my calculator on. Woo! -4.04. But we have that natural log there. How do we get the natural log out? We use our E button, right? Or inverse natural log. And so E to the -4.04 would be our A sub T, which is going to equal 0.0176. Now, real quick check, does that make sense to us? Did the concentration go down? Yes, it did. Awesome. Awesome. Okay? So, we can plug it in and do formulas like that and figure it out that way. All right? That's one way to do it. Okay? Now, rolling on. Our half-life, this half-life formula is actually really important because radioactive decay is something we use. So, another formula... All right. Note our half-life is also constant. That's the other thing that makes this useful. So T1 half equals 0.693 over K. K is our rate constant, and we can solve that. So a first order reaction has a half-life of 25 minutes. If the initial concentration is 0.30, what is the concentration after 50 minutes? So that would be two half-lives, right? So we have two half-lives. So after one half-life, it's 0.15, and then 0.15 divided by 2 is 0.075, and that would be our answer. Okay, there we go. Awesome. Let's move on to the second order integrated rate law. Now, notice how this one's just a touch different here. We have our second order integrated rate law. Okay. Now we have 1 over the concentration and 1 over the initial concentration equals KT. So if we again rearrange this to kind of our YMXB, we've got 1 over A sub T is equal to K sub T. Notice here, slope is going to be positive. All right. And then we have plus 1 over A sub 0. So if we graph concentration, 1 over concentration versus time, and get a straight line, you know it, we have a second order. And that has often been a multiple choice question that they have shown, is that they have three graphs and you have to pick out the line that is straight and you have to say it's zero, first, or second based on the graph. Okay? Or you might have to graph it. If it's on the free response, you might have to graph it. Okay? See you next time.